Hello all. Kindly acknowledge if you are listening or if my voice is audible. Hello. Shall we begin? Okay, fine. So, good evening, all future officers. Okay, so our topic for today is making of the Constitution. My name is Pratik Barge. I am teaching polity here at in SLB Showshot Academy. So let's wait for some time, half a minute, so that our other candidates can join. Let's wait for them, then we will begin our lecture. So yes, it's already 9:05, so we should begin. Firstly, let's make a foundation of this particular lecture. Let me lay the foundation of it. So the first question is, why there is a need of constitution? So as all of you might know that, be it any society, Indian society, or there are so many ancient civilizations, for example Egyptian society, Greek society, Yunnan society, so on and so forth, Chinese society, Indian society, be it any society in any civilization. So to function it properly, there should be, or there is a need of any rule book. For example, in case of India, in ancient times we used to follow the rule book such as Manusmriti. There were also Upanishads, lots of Purans and all. So those were the books, or those were the religious textures, religious text that we used to follow at ancient times. And as all of you know that there was some problem with it. For example, the prominent religious text which dictated the terms at ancient India was Manusmriti, and there were so many lacunas in it. For example, we know the problem of hierarchy in our society. There are mainly four varnas, like Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, and the last one Atishudra. So our Indian society was divided into these five parts. And as all of you know that there was dominance of particular upper caste or upper class on other section of our society. So the Brahmins and Kshatriya used to dominate or rule over other parts of our society. And in that process, the lower strata of our society, that is Dalit or tribes and other people, other castes suffered. So that's why to functioning of any society in proper manner, the rule book should also be good. And that's where the role of constitution comes. So as all of you know that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is regarded as the father of our Indian constitution. Okay. But it will be injustice to our other constitution makers because they also contributed well in that process. So yes, it is the truth that B.R. Ambedkar is the soul of our constitution. He took lots of efforts for fulfilling the Indian dream of making constitution. But there were other people also. Okay, so we will discuss about them in our further slides. So that is the foundation of our today's lecture. Why constitution is important for us? So that it can lay the level playing field in our society. There should be factors like equality, justice in our society. That's the reason why constitution is important. So let's begin with our first slide. Yes, I have stated some of the facts over here, as you can see all. Okay, so the first fact, in 1934, idea of Constituent Assembly was proposed by a very prominent leader of that time, that is M.N. Roy. So M.N. Roy, who is regarded as the tallest personality of Communist Party, as most of you might know that M.N. Roy was used to invited in the international conferences of various Communist Party conferences. He was the special invitee at that time. That was the stature of this particular fellow, M.N. Roy. So he was the one who put forth the idea of Constituent Assembly, and that particular question has been asked so many times in defense examinations and also in other examination. So yes, you have to remember the idea of Constituent Assembly was put forth by M.N. Roy in 1934. So our next point is, in 1935, INC, that is Indian National Congress, demanded to form a Constituent Assembly. So you can see the difference between these two points. In 1934, only the idea was proposed, but in 1935, the demand was there by Indian National Congress for the first time to have a Constituent Assembly so that our great nation, that is India, can form a constitution of its own. Now next point, in 1940, the demand accepted by British government in August offer. So August offer is a catch in this particular point. What is August offer? So you must be well aware that the World War II began in 1939. Okay. So British government at that time was in need to have allies, and India was one of them. So what they did, they proposed some of the benefits to our Indian government of that time or Indian people, so that we can offer them or assist them in their war effort of World War II. That's why they came up with August offer, and in that they accepted the demand to form a Constituent Assembly. So the year is 1940. And our next point is, Cabinet Mission put forth idea of Constituent Assembly. Again, in Cabinet Mission, there were three prominent British leaders or British politicians of that time. They put forth the idea to form a Constituent Assembly. So you need to remember the year and the significance of all those events. So now let's discuss next slide. Again, facts are there, but these facts are important for our examination. So the next fact is, in November 1946, the formation of Constituent Assembly happened. So this is the prominent year and month as far as Indian history, Indian political history is concerned. Formation of Constituent Assembly, because we are demanding, we have been demanding the formation of Constituent Assembly right from 1935, as you can remember from earlier slide. Okay, now, so let's discuss some of the facts which are important from our exam point of view. So the total strength of that Constituent Assembly was 389. Okay, but there was division in it. 296 seats were allotted to only British India, and only 93 seats were allotted to princely states. So the basic difference between British India and princely states is, princely states, they had accepted the authority of British government, but they used to rule by themselves. But if they want to do any policy implementation, they had to take the permission of British government. So that was the case. So there were so many princely states at that time. For example, Junagadh, Hyderabad, the famous Jammu and Kashmir, Kolhapur. So there were so many princely states. So princely states were allotted only 93 states. Okay. Now the next point. On December 9th, 1946, the first meeting of Constituent Assembly was organized. This particular date, December 9, 1946, is very prominent. You have to remember it. Okay. This has been asked in our examination so many times. So the first meeting was held on December 9th, 1946. Another important point, Dr. Sachidananda Sinha was appointed as temporary president. Okay. So he was not the permanent president, as he was the eldest member of Constituent Assembly. That's why he was given the respect in that manner. So he was appointed as temporary president, do remember it. But after some time, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was appointed as the permanent president of Constituent Assembly, who went on to become the first president of India. Okay. Now the next point, two vice presidents were appointed, and the name of those two vice presidents was H.C. Mukherjee and V.T. Krishnamachari. Again, very prominent figures of our Indian polity of that time. So you have to remember three names over here: Dr. Sachidananda Sinha, temporary president; Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was appointed as president slash permanent president; and there were two vice presidents named H.C. Mukherjee and V.T. Krishnamachari. Now next slide, again very prominent event which happened on December 13, 1946. What happened? Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru moved objective resolution. So what do you mean by it? It has been asked so many times in our examination. So by objective resolution, it meant that the fundamental and philosophy of constitutional structure. So you have to consider these both names, both words, objective. Objective means what are the objectives, what are the certain guidelines, what are the fundamental philosophy, in which way we want to head our constitution. Okay, that was the event which happened on 13 December 1946, and that particular resolution was moved by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. And on 26 Jan 1947, finally, that particular resolution, that is objective resolution, was adopted. All these dates are very important for us. It has been asked several times in our examination. Now, the next point, again, some of the facts which are important. The first fact is Constituent Body, which was chaired by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and Legislative Body was chaired by G.V. Mavlankar. So we have to consider here the difference between these two bodies. So what do you mean by Constituent Body? When our members of Constituent Assembly used to gather to form a constitution, to have a debate, discussion over constitution, then that particular body or that assembly used to call Constituent Body or Assembly. But if all the members of Constituent Assembly used to gather for making laws, regulation, rules, etc., then that particular body used to call as legislative body. Okay, so the difference is clear over here, and that particular constituent body was headed by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and the legislative body, that is law making body, was chaired by G.V. Mavlankar. Now the next point, it took 11 sessions over 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. This particular line is very famous as far as our Indian constitution is concerned. It took us 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. So very big time, they toiled hard, they did lots of discussion, they had debates over 11 sessions. They used to gather and they used to have arguments, counter arguments, and in that process our constitution was formed. So this particular line is very important. Now what were the reference for our constitution? So we referred around 60 countries. So we referred constitution of 60 countries, though there are 9 to 10 countries mentioned in our reference book, that is Lakshmikant, but in reality our constitution makers referred near about 60 countries constitution. So you can imagine what kind of effort they took at that time, and the total cost to form our constitution was 64 lakhs. Okay, so total expenditure was 64 lakhs to make our constitution. And the final point of this particular slide, on January 24, 1950, the final session was held. Okay, so on 24 Jan 1950, the final session was held, and in one of state PCS, the question was asked, when the final session was there, what was the weather outside the parliament? Why that question was asked? Because on this particular day, all the members of Constituent Assembly signed the document. Okay, and the weather was asked because, as you can see, in month of January, usually there is a winter season in Delhi, but at that particular day it was raining. So that was the significant moment. Okay, so we took it as in spiritual way. We considered that particular day as auspicious because it was raining on that particular day. Now next slide. So these 7 members were important. Okay, they played very important role for drafting our constitution. And as all of you know, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was spearheading the drafting committee, and he was also the chairman of drafting committee. So which are those 7 members? The first prominent member, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. The second one is N. Gopalaswamy Iyengar. Third, Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer. The fourth one, Dr. K.M. Munshi. Fifth one, Sayyed Muhammad Sadaullah. The sixth one, N. Madhava Rao. And the seventh one, T.T. Krishnamachari. You are supposed to remember all these names because these 7 names has been asked repeatedly in our examination, and the role of these particular 7 people was tremendous to draft our constitution. Okay, now we are moving towards the end of our lecture, but you might be aware of this particular date, that is 26 November 1949. On this particular day our constitution was adopted. You need to remember or understand one particular thing, that there is a difference between adoption and implementation. So on this particular day, that is 26 November 1949, our constitution was adopted. Okay, and that's why our current government started to celebrate that particular day, that is 26 November, as Constitutional Day. Okay, another important event happened on that particular day, which was terror attack on Mumbai. Okay, so on the same day we also celebrate Constitution Day, that is 26 November. Now the next point, our original constitution, when it was adopted, it contained preamble, 395 articles and 8 schedules. But in contemporary time, in today's time, we do have near about 450 articles, 12 schedules and 22 parts. So you can see the changes which has happened over the period of time, okay, in last 60 years as far as our constitution is concerned. So it is a changing documents. We have been adopting the changes, that is amendments. There has been near about 105 amendments till it. So this is the beauty of our constitution, that we can make changes that we want according to the situation. Now next point, which is very important, January 26th was chosen as date of commencement of constitution. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, on 26 November 1949 we adopted the constitution, and on 26 January 1950 we implemented our constitution. But there is one reason behind it. Why did we choose 26 January as the date of commencement, that is the implementation date of our constitution? So there is a very strong and very prominent reason behind it, and that reason is because on this particular day, that is on 26 January in 1930, Purna Swaraj Day was celebrated following resolution of Lahore session of Indian National Congress. So you need to remember, under the leadership of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, that particular day, that is 26 January 1930, was celebrated as Purna Swaraj, that is complete independence. So our sentiments were attached to that particular day, and to respect that particular day, our constitution makers decided to have 26 January 1950 as the date of commencement, that or the date of implementation of our constitution. So this is the prime reason behind it. Okay, now the very last slide of our today's lecture, and I have mentioned some of the facts that you must remember and that will be asked in our examination. The first fact is the symbol of our Constituent Assembly. So the symbol of our Constituent Assembly was elephant, not because our constitution is gigantic or huge, just because it has spiritual background behind it, because elephant is regarded as very holy animal, okay, the symbol of peace. That's why the elephant was accepted as symbol of our Constituent Assembly. The next point, Sir B.N. Rao was appointed as constitutional advisor. So regarding B.N. Rao, he was regarded as the most intellectual person of that time. Okay, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Sir B.N. Rao were some of the person of that time who were regarded as the most intellectual person. Sir B.N. Rao had studied the constitution of so many countries. Okay, he had taken his law degree from London. That was the background of that particular fellow. So he was appointed as constitutional advisor, and this particular question was asked 2 years back in CDS. So you need to remember that particular name. Now the next point, H.V.R. Iyengar was appointed as secretary of Constituent Assembly. So we do ignore or forget such particular facts which are essential for our examination. So we need to remember who was the secretary of Constituent Assembly, H.V.R. Iyengar. Now other points such as Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada, who was the calligrapher of constitution. So Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada, what he did, he wrote the constitution. You must be you must have known calligraphy, the art of calligraphy. So by his own hand he wrote our constitution in English. You have to remember, he wrote our constitution in English. So he made designs, he also depicted the stories of Mahabharata, Ramayana on the corners of our constitution. So the original copy is in Rashtrapati Bhavan. So in future, if you are visiting that place, then this is the must thing that you should see. Now, the beautification and decoration was done by Nandlal Bose and Bihar Ram Manohar Sinha. Yes, as I mentioned, the designs such as flowers, the stories, the depiction of stories of Mahabharata, Ramayana and other Purans. This particular thing was done by Nandlal Bose and Bihar Ram Manohar Sinha. Now, the last point of today's lecture, the calligraphy of Hindi version was done by Vasant Krishnan Vaidya. Okay, so the calligraphy of Hindi was done by Vasant Krishnan Vaidya, and the calligraphy in English was done by Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada. So these are the basic things that you should know about our constitution. So as a citizen, as a aware citizen, it is our duty to know the constitution. Okay, so that's it about today. We will have such lectures in future also, so please stay connected to SSB Show Short YouTube channel. We will bring you the such content in near future also, so stay tuned with us. And if you have any doubt, we do have contact numbers in our description, so you have any doubt or any suggestion for such lectures, you can contact us. Thank you.